need to get rid of that thick area right now before it gets too thin on the sides. So if I hit the base while I'm getting this weight too thin, it'll snap. So now this Cortex material is a little bit softer. Well, it's a lot softer than the material in there. So I'm a little bit worried about being able to run long flakes through there, but I'm going to try anyway. Well, they're going to have a little bit of that Cortex left. Okay, if I can run a flake from this platform here to clear that out, that'll be nice. Almost got it. From here on in, it's just platform preparation and running thinning flakes. And trying to preserve a bold flake pattern if I can. This looks nicer that way. When it's finished, also got to worry about not bridging this point across the pad. got a finer abrading stone or an abrader, but I can't find it. Okay. To create a bold flake pattern, you've got to be aggressive. And to be aggressive, you need to have a lot of material. So, and you've got to have good material that won't snap on you. So right now I'm pushing the limits of the material pretty bad. But it looks like it's working okay. I'll be able to clear those steps from the other side. I'll pressure some crushed areas. I'll pressure those out. Now this is the pass that makes me the most nervous. So it'll determine if I can go any thinner after I do this pass. If I mess up and it stays thick with crushing on the edge, I won't be able to get it very thin. Or ultra thin. And of course I want a bold flake pattern. one more chance to get that off on the next flick. Sweet. Now I'm using copper for this. Of course, they didn't use copper, I don't think, in the Southwest for these really, really thin points. So you may be wondering, how in the heck did they get them that thin? Well, they must have had some sort of hard natural material. If they weren't using copper, they were using some other hard material to concentrate their force. Because peternel chert is not, you know, it's not obsidian. It won't respond to soft antler like obsidian. You gotta have a hard tool to nap with. Okay, I tried to get that step from this side. There's an imperfection there that caused another step. So let's compare. You can see the real one is substantially thinner than mine still. So one more pass on this side and I should get pretty close. Carefully beveling the edge. Might be able to send a flake in there and get that. Of course, it's right in the middle, so gotta be careful not to bridge that point. And I'm going to sharpen my percussion flaker and use percussion on the last pass. Turning the edge, making a very consistent bevel. I'm not creating any isolated platforms, just one continuous platform. I'm not going to abrade it either, because since it is the last pass, I want it to be sharp. I want the edge to remain sharp. So I'm going to be very careful with the bevel. Probably should be using steel. Sun is also creeping up on me, so it'll be right here where I'm napping in a few minutes, so no pressure. Sometimes it makes you wonder, you know, why would they go through so much trouble for a hunting point, a one-shot deal where you know it's going to break. I'm thinking some of these were used for jewelry, because you'll see with this shirt, it's very translucent. It'd be a beautiful piece of jewelry. Okay. I'm going to be taking opportunistic flakes. There's a little bit of a curve to it, and you can see on the real one, there's also a slight curve on the smaller one. So I'm not going to be trying to take that out. What I'm going to try to do is, I'm going to try to remove these lumpy spots. And I'll probably be taking flakes from both sides to take care of that, take care of those lumpy spots, to get a consistent flat surface on both sides. Even though I did turn the edge in one direction, I'm going to be flaking in both directions. We're flaking on both sides. Yeah, I could probably take that out with pressure, but I'm just afraid of snapping the tip off with the pressure flaker. It looks like I might have to. I'm gonna stop messing with that one. Well, that's not good right there, so I gotta try to get that off now. I just took a flake from the other side, hitting in that direction. I mean, from the side of that step, to try to creep up on it from the side. It popped that off, but now behind it, luckily it's not, there's not a thick spot behind it, so it's pretty good. Could have been thinner though. And these ancient knappers really push the material to the limits, because it seems like on most of my points, the thickest area is right in the area where I want to create the notches. So I've got to figure out, as time goes on, as I get more experience, how to make this part thinner than this part. I tend to have the base as the thickest part of the point. And I tend to be notching right where the point is thickest and most difficult to notch. Yeah, that's the kind of flake that I really like at this stage. Okay. And the reason is, I'd rather take one flake like that and then five next to each other, because every time I hit this, it's a chance of breakage. I really want to thin down that tip a little more, so I'm going to be messing with that for a few more minutes here. It's already past 30 minutes. Let's see. And I probably should wait till I finish the notches before I do this. I'm going to do that then. I'll just notch it really quick. They're not going to be very deep. Now, the Harrells didn't really have expanding barbs, so I'm going to take off a little bit from these barbs. Just a little, not too much. I think I just broke off part of that edge. That really bugs me. Anyway. Okay, I'm not going to push it. Harrell's had this basal notch Not sure exactly why they did that. Maybe to thin the base out more. Maybe it helped with the hafting to make it more secure. You see that notch is going right into the thickest part of the point. So on future points, I'm going to try to, I've been trying that for a long time to figure out how to thin the base out more than the body. Sun's in the frame now. Hopefully it won't mess with the lighting too much. I'll just trim the sides and it'll be done. Just want to straighten the edge out. These desert points had really straight edges. Just a few aggressive flakes to try to thin down that tip. Without making it too narrow. Without taking too much time. Okay. All right, that's good enough. Hope that was in the frame. I wasn't even paying attention. Okay. So this is a West Texas type Harrell point. A lot of these had needle tips. And I tried to get it as thin as the illustration. I don't think it is. This book doesn't have any Harrell points in it. It's close. There's a little bit of a constriction in the middle here where I took off that large flake. I can continue to try to take off more mass. You know, I could take off that little bump right here, this one here, and thin out the tip, but I'd lose quite a bit of width. So I'm just gonna leave it that way. And you can see the skill level of the ancient knappers because of the width on this. Substantial width. And you can, you know, near the base here, it's very thin, but my base is thick in comparison. So I still got a ways to go on these ultra thins. But that's a lot of these West Texas Harolds had some of the Cortex and some of the material, the colorful material on the base like this. So I'm happy with it. I like the way that turned out. Okay, that's it.